شعت شموس الهدي بالكلمات، فنارت الأفهام بالآيات. أسرج بنور العلم عقلاً.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين. How should we look at this life which we are living in? The answering this question is really important because the type of outlook we have on this life determines the type of work, actions, and behavior we have in this life. There are three views that we have on this life. And each and one of us must have one of these views. The first view is the negative view that we have through this life. That a person looks at the life in a negative aspect. Poverty, illness, depression, family issue. A person carrying a negative view concentrates on these negative aspects in life. And if this person finds positive aspects in life, they would look at them in a negative view or perspective. This is the negative view, and each and one of us at certain times, especially at times of hardships, we might be inflicted with such a view. There was a famous poet who had a negative view of life. He was an Arab poet and a philosopher named Abu al-Ala al-Ma'arri. It is reported in his biography that he requested the following phrase to be inscribed on his tombstone. What do you want to be inscribed on your tombstone, on your grave? Pay attention to al-Ala al-Ma'arri's view, even after his death. While Nasruddin al-Tusi is also from the 13th century, a Shia scholar and a philosopher, he requested to be buried beside the shrine of Imam al-Kadhim alayhi salam, and he wanted the following Quranic verses to be inscribed on his tombstone. And their dog stretched his four legs at the entrance. In Arabic or Persian, the word dog represents absolute humility before the master. However, the poet Al-Ma'arri asked that the following to be inscribed on his tombstone. هذا جناه أبي علي. This death is what my father brought upon me. He means that it was my father's fault that I came into this world and he's finally had to die. Al-Ma'arri viewed this life as a crime, as he considered granting life, giving birth to someone, is a crime. This is a very dangerous view. An illness that is spread around the world today is depression. This illness did not really exist in the past, or existed but in very limited circles. In the past, whenever you'd meet a person, they were generally cheerful. They had good spirits, their souls and hearts were joyful, they were living happy and enthusiastic. However, among the significant and dangerous illnesses around the world today is depression. Hearts are no longer lively, faces are gloomy. Why? It is all due to this negative view, in which sometimes drives a person to even commit suicide, as he or she loses all their hope in their life. And all they think about is that death will bring them comfort. Alhamdulillah, believers are not much affected by this. This is a result of having a negative view in this life. The second view is the recreational view, which views nothing but entertainment and fun. Those people who live this life in distraction and amusement, إنما الحياة الدنيا لهو ولعب, The Quran states that this worldly life is not but diversion and amusement. Some youth have this view towards life. Imam Ali alayhi salam in the book Nahj al-Balagha, Peak of Equivalence, says, فَمَا خُلِقْتُ لِيَشْغَلَنِي أَكْلِ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. I wasn't created to simply enjoy the delicious and tasty. Unfortunately, youths today, all they think about is eating, sleeping, playing soccer, or other games. Is this what life means to them? Imam Ali alayhi salam gives a description of the third caliph, and I don't think that there is more reprimanding and reapproaching description than the Imam's description. Imam Ali alayhi salam says that he is between his dunk and fooder, meaning that one's concern is all about what to eat, just like the animal. Is there a harsh description than this? Life has become about eating, drinking, sleeping, and then life is over. This view, which is adopted by some youths, is also dangerous. Why? It's because this view impacts one's life by making them going backwards. It impedes progress. This view gives a youth and a young adult to feel that they're worthless about themselves. They make them feel that they don't have any significance in life. And a young man and woman must have significance and influence in life. This is the second view on life. The first view was the negative view. The second view is the recreational view. Now the third view is what is pointed out by Imam Ali alayhi salam in Nahj al-Balagha, in Peak of Equivalence. This book is among the oppressed books. Many of us have oppressed this book. It is one of the books that shows us the correct path to take in our lives. It represents the path of advancement. A Western scholar once said, if Muslims would have implemented the teaching of the book of Peak of Equivalence, Nahj al-Balagha, they would become the masters of this world. Are we the masters of this world? Are we at the peak of this world, or are we at the end of the line? Who makes the decisions today in this world? We Muslims or the non-Muslims? Who holds power and authority? We must pay attention to the book, Peak of Equivalence. Our youth must memorize it, Nahj al-Balagha. And they must memorize the Quran also. The same way that we must memorize the Quran, we must read the book Nahj al-Balagha, Peak of Equivalence, and memorize it. Anyhow, Imam Ali alayhi salam points out the third view on life. And this view is the purposeful view on life. The source of this statement by Imam Ali alayhi salam, Peak of Equivalence, is in number 131. Imam Ali alayhi salam heard a man condemning this world and life. This is the first view that people have in life. The negative view, you find it in poets, in authors, in elderly people who are older in age and they suffer from illnesses, those people who are in businesses and losing money, you see them slandering this life. Imam Ali alayhi salam said to that man who was condemning this world, and pay attention to what the Imam said to him. Imam Ali alayhi salam describes this world and he says to him, O you who are condemning this world, إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا دَارُ صِدْقٍ لِمَنْ صَدَقَهَا. The world is a place of honesty to whomever is honest with it. This world speaks to us. It tells the truth about itself. The world tells us, be aware of my tyranny and devastation. This is the world. It warns us. Do we trust it? Then the Imam continues and he says, وَدَارُ عَافِيَةٍ لِمَنْ فَهِمَ عَنْهَا. And it is a place of wellness for those whom understand it. This world teaches us the truth. It is a place of wellness if we understand this world and comprehend it, whether this world is the place of affliction or wellnesses. Then the Imam Ali عليه السلام says, وَدَارُ غِنَاءٍ لِمَنْ تَزَوَّدَ مِنْهَا. And it is a place of richnessness for whomever packs from it and takes as much as he can from it. We secure our hereafter from this world. Every supplication we recite, any deed we do, any good deed will transfer into a tree in paradise. We construct here for the hereafter by enriching your deeds in this world. Then the Imam says, وَدَارُ مَوْعِظَةٌ لِمَنِ اتَّعَظَ مِنْهَا. And it is a place where you take advice from it. Everything in this world teaches us advice. Poverty teaches us. Everything teaches us. وَمَسْجِدْ أَحَبَّاءِ اللَّهِ. And it is the mosque of where you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمُصَلَّى مَلَائِكَةِ اللَّهِ. And the angels of Allah pray in this world. How many years do they pray for? Probably a fraction of their prayers. Might last 1,000 years. وَمَهْبُطْ وَحْيِ اللَّهِ. And it is a place which Allah's revelation descended. Where did Allah's revelation descend? In this world. In this place. This is the most beautiful definition of this world. فَمَنْ ذَا يَذِمُّهَا. The Imam says, so who condemns it? Who is condemning this world? It does not deceive us. It revealed to us its reality. It revealed to us the true nature to people. This world tells us that I'm temporary stage. It has been narrated once that an angel of death came to a person, to a man. The man said, why have you come to me? The angel replied and said, I'm here to take your soul. The man said, why did you not warn me? The angel of death said to him, I gave you many warnings. The man said, when? The angel of death replied to him and said, didn't one of your relatives die? That was the first warning. Didn't one of your loved ones die? That was your second warning. All these are warnings for us. And the first white hair that you see on your face is a warning. All these are warnings and signs of departure. This world is truthful. It says, I am not an internal home. I am only a temporary home for you to get ready to the hereafter. وَنَادَتْ بِفِرَاقِهَا. It informed that I will perish. I will be gone. You will be gone. وَنَعَتْ نَفْسَهَا وَأَهْلَهَا. This world is mourning itself and mourning us. And then Imam Ali says, by its hardship, it set an example of their hardships. By its pleasure, it created eagerness for the pleasures of the next world. There are many pleasures here in this life. However, they always remember or remind us that there are bigger everlasting pleasures that don't even compare to the pleasures here. Sayyid Muhammad Rida Shirazi mentioned once that he was on his way to Mashhad and he became along a very beautiful scenery on his way. Trees, mountains, river, lakes. An older friend who was accompanying him said, this is the prison of the believer, because it's narrated by the Imams that Ad-Dunya Sujn al-Mu'min, this world is like a prison to the believers. Anyway, so he said that this is the believer's prison, the believer's paradise. How does it look like? If this pleasure and this life is very joyful for you, then what would you expect for the pleasures of paradise be like? Imam Ali alayhi salam then continues and he said, فَمَثَّلَتْ لَهُمْ بِبَلَائِهَا وَشَوَّقَتْهُمْ بِسُرُورِهَا إِلَى السُّرُورِ. Meaning by its hardships, it set an example for their hardships. And by its pleasure, it created eagerness for the pleasures of the next world. It brings ace in the evening and grief in the morning. Then the Imam says, رَاحَةٌ فِي عَافِيَةٌ وَابْتَكَرَتْ بِفَجِيعَةٌ. It's not lying to us. You see, someone at night is in full health, and then in the morning you hear grief. Meaning that one would sleep with good health, nothing is wrong with them. But in the morning you hear that they died. تَرْغِيبًا وترهيبا, meaning the way of persuasion and discouragement, alarm and warning. فذمها رجال غداة الندامة. Some people condemn this world when they become regretful of the wrong things that they did in this world, while others will praise this world on the day of judgment. Some people will say, Alhamdulillah, we passed. We're successful. We passed in this world. How much are we going to live in this life? It's unknown. We might live for 10 years. We might live for 80 years. We might live for 90 years, maybe less. However, we have to work as much as we can for the hereafter. There was a king who was with his advisors and guards in a palace. And suddenly he hears a noise outside from the palace. So he took a peek to see what's the issue, what's going on inside my palace. And he sees a man, a poor man, wanting to enter his palace. But the guards would not let him, would not allow him to enter. So the man was shouting, "Why are you preventing me to enter? Isn't this a lounge, a place to rest?" The king became very angry and said, "How could this poor man think that my palace is a lounge and a resting room? Let him come in." Once he got in front of that man, or that man stood before the king asked him, "What did you want?" The man replied, "I just wanted to rest in this place and leave." The king asked, "Then why did you say it was a resting room and a lounge?" The old man replied, he said, "Who did this palace belong to before?" The king answered and he said, "It belonged to my father." The man asked, "Before that, who did it belong to?" The king said, "My grandfather." Then he said, "And after that, after you pass away, who will this palace belong to?" The king said, "My son." The poor man, he concluded, and he said, "Isn't this a resting room? Isn't this a place where you rest and you leave?" This conversation inspired Ibrahim ibn Adham. He realized that this world is worthless. And at night, he took off his royal clothing and dressed up old clothing and went to live in a desert. And he became a devoted worshipper to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim ibn Adham. His grave today is in Syria and it's been visited by many people. Therefore, these are limited and counted days that we should use them wisely and build for the hereafter. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina wa nabina Muhammadin wa ala ali baytihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin.
إن الدنيا دار صدق لمن صدقها ودار عافية لمن فهم عنها ودار غنى لمن تزود منها. في هذه الدنيا نعمر آخرتنا. كل ذكر نقوله لا إله إلا الله سبحان الله الحمد لله, كل واحد منها شجرة في الجنة.